Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Stalker. As per usual, we're jumping on in here. Now, this is probably going to load maybe a little quicker than usual because this is actually my second time going at this, and the reason behind that is because I had my volume set up too high, and Stalker, for whatever reason, blocks all global hotkeys, which makes actually recording this kind of a pain in the ass. But that's okay. I only recorded for like 2 minutes before I was like, no, I can't stand the volume being too loud. It was loud enough that I pulled my headphones back up my ears a little bit. And like my gunfire, like that, my mic was picking it up. Which, you know, that's a little much, I think. So, yeah, no more of that. Plus, you know, it was not deafeningly loud, but loud enough that I didn't want to deal with it. So what are we doing today? Well, we are gonna go talk to those bandits. Eventually. I hear dogs. I hear them. Oh, it's not dogs. It's killer guinea pigs. Where's my pistol? Little shits. Thought it was dogs. Those things are like this game's version of the rad roach. I wanna see what's in here. See if there's anything worthwhile. Hey there, frame rate. Come on now. Calm yourself. I don't know what your deal is, but I'm in the mood here. Go ahead and flip my light off. I don't think I need that on during, you know, the day. So nothing too interesting in there. Oh, can we go into the bathrooms? These are always, let's see, these are always horror shows, but you know, in here it's just some toilets. Alright. Can't do anything with this. No. Other bathrooms. Go ahead, flip my light back on. Again? Not looking like anything. I mean, this is tipped over, but whatever. Okay, I'm gonna pull out my PDA really quick and go ahead and, oh, we have a stash down there, good to know. The stingray, and we wanna go here? Yes. All right. That I'm gonna go investigate because, you know, loot. We can't pass that up. Although previously the loot's been kind of mediocre. It was actually mentioned to me by a commenter, I apologize for not recalling your name at the moment, that stashes that are like up on ledges and stuff, apparently you can shoot them to knock the items down. I actually didn't know that items in this reacted to bullet physics. So I didn't, you know, think to try doing that. But now that I know, we will do so. So thank you, I appreciate that. So let's see, got anything interesting in these? Because if I do anything, it's get distracted by the terrain. It's so weird being able to just do this and build and like through doorways in this because I've been playing, I know I've mentioned it probably a lot more than I should be and I'm sure it's getting annoying to some of you, but I've been playing a lot of Arma and in that game it actually models like your rifle and stuff. So if you try to step through a door like this with say, you know, like, damn it, like an assault rifle out like this, and you do this, you get hung up on the door, and it's actually quite annoying. It makes navigating buildings very difficult, which is probably intentional on the developer's part, because, you know, you can't side strafe through doorways holding your rifle straight up, but it gets kind of annoying. There was actually a mod for Arma 2 that removed that, however, I don't believe it got ported to Arma 3. I'm curious what's in there. I hear gunfire. I see gunfire. Probably bandits. Oh yeah, whoever it is, it's hostile. My aim is terrible. Oh, zombies? I think it's zombies. Yeah, zombies. I think. Maybe not. I don't know, I can't tell. I don't think it's zombies. I think it was bandits. You bastards, I know there's stalkers out there. You bastards, these are my loot. No, they were zombies. I'm just a jackass. I couldn't tell because I heard the other guys talking. And so I'm like, oh, it's people, but they're hostile, so bandits. But it was in fact zombies. Hey, some anti-rad drugs. I'm actually really pleased by that. What is this? Is mine? Get out of here, you jerks. Shoot some 45. I bet you that is probably... Yeah, substantially more damage than... we'll try it. Why not? It's in slightly less awesome repair than our current gun. This is like a Deagle, I think. The gun sounds in this, the sound effects for firearms are just so disappointing. Hey guys, I'll leave you alone. They just really lack the punch that, I don't know, that they should have, and it's kinda, eh. Oh, hey, radiation. And I'm not even gonna be like, you know, well, most games don't do that. That's not true, it's just a problem that Stalker's kind of always had. It's kinda there in Fallout 3 as well, although there are some guns in that that have really satisfying sound effects, so overall it kinda gets a pass. But I always felt like the guns in this, it was like firing off, like, I don't know, cap guns or something. I don't know. Maybe I'm just being nitpicky. This is an older game. I can't be expecting, like, the best of everything from it. I mean, it's not, you know, destroying my immersion or anything. Now, those flat leaves on the trees, on the other hand, my immersion is dead. You only really notice it if you're actually paying attention to them, which I'm generally speaking not. Hey guys, I'm peaceful. I'm peaceful. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13.
I'm all ears, buddy.
Did they seriously? Oh, okay, there's a guy standing there. I thought they hung somebody. I'm like, Jesus Christ. You can get out of my way, or am I gonna have to blow your freaking brains out? I have to speak to Jax about Vano's debt. Go on then. Oh man. I'm gonna quick save here, and if this turns to violence, it turns to violence.
Would you look at that? The man himself.
The man himself, huh? Well, come in, what do you want? I'm here to pay Vano's debt. 7 G's including interest. Interest wasn't part of the deal. What are you talking about? Do you take me for a sucker, lending out cash without charging interest? It's 7 G's and that's the end of it. Think carefully now, I've got a shooter here and I don't mind using it. Tell me, what's your corpse gonna do with all that interest? Huh, show me a piece. Oh, 7 G's. I'll think about it. I am going to think long and hard. I thought about it and found your deal wanting. I like this gun. But I have a feeling that this is probably, I was gonna say, we have bullet piercing on walls. Probably not. That's probably asking a little much. Ow! Ow! Sit! Ah, bleeding. 3! Door? No. 4! Oh, ho, 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 ho. Jesus Lord! Shotgun! Well, I cleared the dude's dead. Oof, that was immediate. I was not expecting that. I dropped that other guy and I'm like, oh man, I'm boss. That's less than boss. He's actually got a really nice shotgun too.
Holster that shooter, Stalker, or I'm putting you right in the ground.
Holster your shooter, huh? God, just uncontrollable. Just uncontrollable. Right, so that's 2. Well, 1 actually. Why did I pull that out? One of my damn grenades. 4 is grenades, I have to remember that. Okay, I think that was the dude. I'm gonna start pitching him out the damn windows. Eat him! Choke on him! Uh-oh. Woo! No. Yes. Alright, 1, 2, 3, 4 I've killed, at least. Woo! Nobody's gonna miss some bandits. Oh, they're coming for me. They're coming for me. Oh, that was terrible. Gotta make sure. I actually quite like the ragdoll physics in this, which I will say I like the ragdoll physics in this over Arma. Yeah, he wasn't dead. I definitely prefer the ragdoll physics in this over Arma. Arma just uses like stock Havoc physics, which I have always thought were terrible. I mean, the body just ragdolls. There's no like weight to any of it, so it just kind of looks terrible. I actually prefer the like death animations from like Arma 2 to the death animations in Arma 3. Just because they are, I don't know, Havoc physics, like I said, it's just never really done it for me. Now, if they were using whatever the hell they use in Grand Theft Auto, the newer Grand Theft Auto is like 4 and 5, I would be all over that, because those games actually have really, really good, oh, that's a grenade. Those games actually have really, really good ragdoll physics, but I believe that is a proprietary engine, so that's not gonna be, that's not gonna be something that gets released, I don't think. All right, so there's one out to the right. You dicks, you're terrible. I say as they put holes in me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, I think. 8, maybe? So there's like 5 left. I'm actually gonna quick save. Why not? I'm pretty confident in my ability to off all of these jackets. Alright, yeah, there's one over there by the building, and I know there's a guy over here just lurking in those bushes. You cheeky sucker. I don't know where he is. Because the bushes are giving him cover. I think I might have just killed him. I'm not 100%. Dead. So that's 4, 8, 10, 12. There's one left. Did I get this guy? Yes. Where is he? Oh, there he is. 13. In theory, I was gonna say, yeah, that's all of them. Haha! Victory. Oh, we are gonna get so much crap. I'm okay with that. Freaking assholes. Extorting all that money. I hope he lets me keep it. I guess. Because, you know, money. This thing's actually not in good enough condition as I sit here slowly radiating. Okay, there's a bunch of them. I'm sure this is gonna give me a little glow. Because it seems like every vehicle in this game is just irradiated. Yeah, I can hear it clicking away a little bit there. I don't know why, but it kind of annoys me when you try to take ammo and it doesn't take all of it with one click. Maybe you have to like click and drag to automatically do that. Did I grab that? Yeah, I did accidentally grab this shotgun. I do not want this thing, actually. And I'll get them on my way out. I want to see what this dude back here had, because he had like a, it looked like an automatic shotgun, like a semi-auto shotgun. And naturally, I must have it. Okay. Now, I'm sure you guys have noticed that by, no, it does only take one. Well, that's just obnoxious then. But I'm sure you guys have noticed that I'm not exactly going through this in the normal pacifist route like I would if I were playing, like, say, Fallout, and that is because I'm not playing one of my own characters. I'm playing the Major, who's here to basically kick ass and take names. Alright, so what do you have? You got all this, which I don't really particularly care about. It's that shotgun you've got laying next to you, Jack, that I'm most interested in. Give me that. Alright, yeah, I'm encumbered, I don't care. What is this thing? Eliminator, a smoothbore combat revolver type shotgun intended to provide extreme firepower for militarized units. Yes. Why, thank you. Damn, that weight. Ugh. I might have to get rid of my Deagle. But I don't wanna, so I'm not gonna. It's okay, we'll just take our time. We don't move that slowly. We'll see if maybe I can like eat some food or something, get us down. I can always drop food and stuff, because I was gonna say, yeah, we're gonna be picking up some extra stuff here. So once I'm done looting, we'll, you know, figure out what we wanna do. Hey there, bud. A lot of these guys have these rifles that I've got, which I can actually appreciate because it means I get bullets for the thing. So, okay, I think I just picked that one up. I really don't like that the F key is what both displays, like here. See if it'll do it. See, you can see the TRS-301 there. I don't like that it both displays what items are as well as picking them up. Kind of obnoxious, but eh. Certainly something that can be worked around. Not a big deal in the grand scheme of things. Okay. Thanks, Shrik. See, I don't care about this guy's gun. I'm not gonna be grabbing all of their guns and unloading them. Just if they've got one of what I have, I will. Okay, and I accidentally picked up that gun. F to leave inventory, F to loot. It's just, eh. Oh, I was gonna say, I don't even know how I killed this guy, but it must have been one of those grenades I pitched out there. And yeah, I was gonna say, I just picked up another damn gun. Where is it? This thing. Get out. I say, yeah, we are like right on the cusp of truly over encumbered. Like, I have a feeling we're not gonna be able to move now. Oh, shit. Sorry, dude. You're really dead now. Okay, let's drop this thing. Do I really need 21 grenades? No. Do I want them? Yes. See, I'm sure I'm still, yeah. Well, here, I can drop some stuff onto this guy's body. Can I double click to drop them? Yes. All right, there we go. Drop some grenades. Keep all one kind. Got some F1s, defensive, and these are offensive, right? 5 meters, 7 meter kill radius. I want those, they have a larger kill radius. Okay, energy drink can go. Do I really need all of this vodka? No. Five of those. Not much. Yeah, like this food is actually surprisingly heavy. I'm gonna keep the tourist breakfasts, but other stuff, I don't really need. Oh, here you go. 20% carrying capacity, or not 20%, 20 kilogram extra carrying capacity. Bam, for I think it's like 5 minutes, 300 seconds, yeah. So this should enable us to basically loot to our heart's content, get back to town, sell crap, and be good to go. Give me all of your everything, sir. Where is it? There it is. That. None of their guns are in particularly good condition, which is kind of disappointing, but whatever. We made out like a bandit. Ugh. All right. We actually have quite a bit of ammo for this thing now too, which I actually think I'm probably gonna primary this thing. It's gonna probably do, I'd say it will be more effective than our other weapon. And since it's only a 7-round clip on it, it'll be, I'll probably be a little bit more careful with it too. I don't think I'll be spraying bullets like I usually do. I'm within 10 of my carrying capacity. Yeah, I was gonna say, I shouldn't have run out of stamina that quick. That's okay. Not too worried. Stamina does tick back up pretty quickly, which I'm thankful for. So I'll just kind of run when I can and be good when I'm not. I'm gonna have to remember that Hercules stuff, not to sell it. That'll be certainly something to keep mindful of. I wonder where that bloodsucker that was out here, you know, a couple episodes ago, I wonder where that thing got off to. I don't think that monsters have, you know, lairs in this. It's like it didn't go home, it just despawned type thing, but still, it's kind of curious. I do want to see what's in there, too. We'll poke around in that. Okay, we'll tell this guy we took care of the bandits. Maybe that'll actually get us some rep with these dudes, because I basically took out that entire bandit camp single-handedly.
I'm listening.
Alright, where was this fella? Was it...
Well, spill it!
Was it you? No, I did sniping with you, Uncle Yar, because...
I'm listening, man.
You remind me of... What's his name? God damn it, I forgot it. I can't even... Oh, man, my memory is just so bad, guys. So bad. Steve Buscemi, there we go. Bam! The you? Man, oh, yeah. They were arrogant bastards. I took them out. Wow, you're hardcore. Thank you so much. Keep the money. Yeah, that was meant to pay off the debt. Now it'll go to someone who deserves it. I'll see you, man. Oh, that's sweet. I'm glad. All these guys are going out. These glorious bastards.
Come on over, bro.
Hey, bro. Bro, how are you doing, bro? You ever bro? I'm not gonna razz it too hard. I'm just bitching. All right, so let's see what we can offload here. I'm gonna offload Actually, I want to keep those because they have the larger kill radius. I will get rid of these. Now, it does say that these guys have infinite money, but they do have a trade limit. I don't think we're going to hit it anytime soon, but I believe it's 100,000 rubles. So you can't trade with them for larger sums than that at once. You can do it in multiple transactions, but you just can't do it all at once. And so I have a feeling that's enough for me on food. So 1,400 rubles, go ahead and get rid of this stupid thing. Okay, this guy, I'm gonna keep just for now. Take it easy. I have a feeling—
Hop in sometime, it can be fun around here.
You're crazy. I have a feeling we're gonna be getting rid of it at some point, but for the time being, I wanna just hold on to it. Hey there. Okay, what can you do with this fella? Increased mag size, lower weight. How much does this thing weigh? It's not that heavy. Ah, it's actually quite heavy. All right, sure. Yes, fire rate. I don't think that's too necessary. Less recoil, yes. Oh, okay, so that was a choice there. I only got one. I got recoil over handling. I'm okay with that. I like that they give you the choice like that. Like, you've got to make choices between things. That's pretty cool. Mag size, I mean, like, why wouldn't I, logically speaking? But part of me thinks that if I have a larger magazine, I'm going to spray bullets. So that'll get me up to 11, right? Yeah, what's this thing? Thing's 12. Yeah, we'll go for it. Why not? Okay, so we're going to repair it. Repair our helmet. Our armor, I don't think. Wow. Actually, that cost more to repair than I thought it would. Okay. This guy. Repair. Oof, that's pricey. Okay, so we have a decent amount of ammo for this thing. What do we got here? Reliability. Yes, because I want this thing to last and less recoil. Oh, man. I'm going to do some damage with this. This is going to be... This is gonna be violent. I'm carrying like 5 guns. I don't need to be carrying, you know, this many weapons. It's just not a good idea. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and increase the magazine size on this. I think that was like 1,000 there. I'm not too particularly worried. You know, easy come, easy go. So I believe that is about it. Let's see here. See ya. He did mention materials. We'll be doing probably a mission.
See you around.
We'll be probably doing a mission for him before too long. I wonder if there's like an arms trader here. Not only that, I want to know if there's a place to stash all my crap. Who are you? Oh yeah, he was giving me mutant hunting. Let's see, is this my stash? This is my stash. Oh, it's not shared. Ooh, I don't know about that. I'm gonna leave this behind. Leave all of this behind because it's like freaking 30 pounds of bullets. I guess I use that, I use that, I use that, and I use those. So I do not use, I don't need to use this. Jesus, I just use like, okay, I want a lot of like all of my ammo that I actually have on me. That's the problem. I think too heavily equipped here. I mean, I've got 3 fully automatic weapons. All right, we're gonna leave this guy behind because we only have 57 rounds for it. We'll stick to our better one for the time being. Okay, and this thing, I don't know what I'm supposed to do with it. I'm gonna hold on to it, and I didn't actually sell that, so. All right, so we just dropped, I think, like 10 kilograms worth of junk. So, like, well, not junk, but stuff. Okay, let me bring up my map here and zoom in. That is useless. Okay, so we have a guide and we have something down there. We have a trader, medic, technician. Looks like maybe another trader behind us. No. Oh, they got a guitar going. That's something I remember very, I wouldn't say necessarily fondly, but I remember that from the first game, Shadow of Chernobyl, was the people playing guitar. You see, okay, so you're the guy that brought me here. You just have random crap I don't care about. Okay, see ya. So, dude bro in here, Mr. Repair. You mentioned materials. Right, finding materials for use for working with radio equipment is damn near impossible around here. used everything I could find, and there's nobody supplying any materials here, because you can't make any cash selling, because you can make more cash selling guns. I heard there could be something left at the cement factory, though. Well, I can check it out. That'd be great. If you could find anything like colophonium or capacitors, bring them to me. Hell, I'd even be grateful for some textilite. Can't promise you a lot of cash, but you'll get a discount, that's for sure. Alright, see ya. So we have a new mission. I'm gonna quick save.
No matter what you give them, they always want
to. Okay. Give me my map. Where am I going? Is this the cement factory by any chance? No. Damn it. Yeah, I should have come down here, but I wasn't thinking because we were so overburdened. That's okay. So is this the cement factory? Yes. Just making sure. I know our map marker is there, but I wanted to make sure it wasn't for like a different quest or something. I want to check this place out. This is my immediate goal. God, this gun is so awesome. Ah, I love it. And this. Oh, that reload animation. That's going to be a nightmare. If I've got like something trying to eat my face off. Ah, door's locked. Wait, I just have to holster my weapon, huh? All right, weapon holstered. Hello? I bring vodka and canned delicious foods. Stairs scare me. That's Arma's fault because you fall through them 3/4 of the time. Okay. Ah. Hey there. What's up, bro? Obviously, I'm glad to see you, but I wouldn't mind being my own for a while either. Alright, Zulu. Got a nice place here. Why does everybody just have the. Ooh. Looks like a PKM or something. Light machine gun. Give me an M249. You glorious bastards. Give me my saw that I might smite my foes. I don't know. I still think that if they were to port these maps into Arma, it'd be great. I would play the hell out of this. Mostly because you can actually like enter all of the buildings and stuff, which the closest thing, well, in Arma 3's maps, you can, I think you can actually enter probably 99% of the buildings. I know there are a couple that you can, but the closest map in Arma to like this style of terrain is actually Chernogorsk, which is from Arma 2, and it very much has a stalker feel to it. Not necessarily like the post-apocalyptic, but it's like a Russian. It's based in Russia, I believe. It is based on Russia because the opposing force in that game is actually Chernorussian or whatever. And so it very much has this feel to it. And if you just like layer fog in properly and stuff, you can very much get like the stalker eeriness going on. The problem is, it was developed at a time where they really weren't doing like enterable buildings. So in Chernogorsk, you can really only enter, like, I would be probably generous in saying one of every 5 to 8 buildings. It's not common. So having something like this where you can enter all of the buildings and you get that really cool, I shouldn't say cool, but you get the Russian terrain style, I think it would be really cool. Oh, are you hostile? Yes. Zombie. Oh, that's right, this thing has a silencer on it. I totally forgot about that. Oh, you bet your ass it's shotgun time. I don't know what kind of ammo's in this thing. It's buckshot. Yes. What do I have otherwise? Slug rounds. Let's go ahead and let's see, what is my... Gotta check hotkeys. We're gonna probably run a little over today. Change the ammo time. It is Z. I just apparently can't load slugs into this thing. That makes me kind of sad. Don't think I didn't hear you bastard shooting at me. Where are you? I'm ready. Did it kill itself? I don't know. We're gonna go up and find out though. This is like the stupidest thing you can do in a game with like realistic gun physics. I'm gonna just run up this giant tunnel of murder, make an obvious target of myself. Whoa. Whoa. Zombies, man. They can't aim. Whatever. Echo detector. I'm pleased with the fact that I shot him once with a shotgun and he died, although admittedly I kind of took my time there and pointed it straight at his head. this is pretty effective. I'm pretty happy with this thing thus far. I'm just saying. Okay, he's dead. I'm just making sure. Yeah, gotta check your targets before you do any looting. It's actually one thing I appreciate about the Ace mod in Arma 3. When you play the base game, you can tell very obviously when someone is dead because they just ragdoll. Ace, on the other hand, adds like the ability to bleed out and stuff, and it's actually, I wouldn't say impossible, but it's quite difficult to land a shot on somebody that just flat out kills them, even if you wing them in like the head. Sorry, dude, but I need your stuff more than you do. Even if you wing them in the head, typically it's not a kill wound because they have helmets on and stuff. They're just, you know, traumatized, obviously, and bleeding. So with Ace, you might think you killed like a group of guys that you attacked, and you'll be there like rifling through their shit, and one of them will regain consciousness and just waste your ass, which I think it adds a really cool dynamic because it's gonna sound horrible, but it basically encourages you to double tap, and I love it. Oh, you see now that just scares the shit out of me. So you know there's gonna be something interesting down there. There we go. I was gonna say, am I stuck? No. All right. Such a waste of shotgun ammo. God, this thing is awesome. Any more? I'm actually gonna come in here really quick. Switch over that. Why did it unload the ammo? I do not know. Go ahead and reload here, and we'll continue. Yeah, I fear nothing. I have a shotgun now. Fear is no longer in my dictionary. I say moments before probably screeching because something's going to jump out at me and I'm a total puss. But hey. I don't know. Ooh, is that a thing? Those are things right there. Those are medkits. All right, so let's see if the shooting trick works. Yeah, it actually does kinda. Army medkit, can I just... Here. Okay, so this is... Captain Plant says if you aim while you're crouching... I don't know. Doesn't really seem like it's doing anything to me. I just gotta get up around here. Man, I want those. Those are good medkits. Can I? I feel like such an asshole doing this. Here you go, guys. Did that dislodge them? Eh, a little bit. Come here. Why would you do this to me again? There's batteries back there. I don't even know what those do, but I want them. I don't know. I can't get back there. I'm not gonna waste shotgun shells on this either. Whatever, we got two of them. I'm okay with that. Army medkits are actually pretty good. Here, this is where we go up, yes. All right, well in that case, can I just like come over here and drop down? No, no. Why, game, why? Oh, there's a ladder here too, I didn't even notice that. Okay, well that was certainly a thing. Less terrifying than I thought it would be, but whatever. I'm gonna check up in here and then we'll hit the next area and see if we can find this guy's tools or components, I should say. For all I know, that battery is one of the components, but I have a feeling that that was actually a stash we just found there and I just kind of happened to luck out a little bit in finding it. All right, well this place looks like 5 floors, including ground, so 4 floors we'll say. I got some radiation going on. Go ahead and solve that problem. Okay, so what are we looking at? Oh, the stairs collapsed. And you can't pull yourself up ledges. Well, that's troublesome. Let's see here. Ah, there we go. Secondary entrance. Gotta be aware of your surroundings, guys. Oh no, more of the lightning bullshit. Oh yay, rain. Truly new and interesting. Because we haven't seen enough rain in our time. Whoa, shuttlecock. I didn't even see that thing. Yeah, I mean, it's there, obviously. I wonder if that's probably just an alternate way to get up here. Oh, there's something up there. Let me pull out my bolts. Can we make a beeline for it? Yeah, okay. All right, I'm gonna go back in here actually and switch those out. I hear gunfire. Oh yeah! What the shit was that? I think that might've been a vulture. Looks like a mask and everything. Yeah, stash found. Damn right a stash was found. Found a bunch of med kits and a mask. What is this, a tactical helmet? Okay, so we're losing out on chem protection, I believe. Yeah. So we're losing on chem, we're losing on rad protection. We are gaining a crap ton of psionic protection and a boatload of armor. Wow, this actually provides us with no armor. So yeah, we're switching over to that. I think I'll probably hold on to this. Maybe. Like, if we decide to go into an area that is irradiated or whatever, I can go back to my stash and just grab it. But for the time being, I am all for some extra armor. And I did pop my other Hercules simply because... Seriously. Simply because I didn't want to have to deal with fiddling with dropping stuff here. Okay. Well, that's damage. Alright. Is this a thing? Yeah, radio equipment. Is that going to be the only one? Probably. But I will... Ow. I'll check around. Oh yeah, that's a death trap, I betcha. What is this? Fuego. Okay. What is this? I have no idea what that was. Box of transistors. Oh man, I'm gonna do it. Oh man, that was probably stupid in hindsight, but looks like some computer chips, some computer boards, I should say. I was gonna say, I should just hold down the F key so that this stuff highlights. Oh, and we're hungry. Delicious. Delicious diet sausage. What is diet sausage? What even is diet sausage? I don't know. Would you eat diet sausage? I wouldn't touch it. I mean, regular sausage is like, probably when you think about it, the less desirable parts. Well, not really, but you guys know what I mean. It's not, you know, pork cutlets or whatever. Oh. Okay, there's obviously something here that wants to mate. Is it here? I don't know. Taking that, some capacitors. Copper wire. I don't know if this guy needs all of this or if he just needs like one of them, but we're gonna grab as much of it as we can. Just to textilite base. Just kind of be useful here. Nice. Okay. I don't even know like what that's supposed to be. I'm sure that this has a name. Like what it actually is. Can't tell. A can of colophonium, okay. Oh yeah. Oh man, I'm a ninja here. All right, so let's see what our mission log says here. Radio equipment, find materials. Oh, it doesn't detail any more than that, huh? Message log, no. That is less than useful unless there is, you know, a more in-depth mission log. I assume it's just telling us to go back there. So we will finish poking around. I'm sure this is just gonna take us, yeah, this is exactly what I figured. It's just gonna take us right back here where we entered. All right, that actually wasn't too bad. I do wanna hustle back to base though, hey guys, because this Hercules is only gonna last so long and we're probably carrying quite a few pounds of crap, to be honest. Alright, and of course, you know, it's pouring. Yeah, we're at 56. That's not as much as I thought it was, but it's still gonna be enough to... Jesus Christ. Freaking lightning storm. The weather just couldn't be any better here, and you know this is probably like acid rain or something. I don't know, part of me remembers there being acid rain in Shadow of Chernobyl. That might just be me being weird. But I don't know. Part of me seems to remember having to take cover from the rain. I don't know though, might be something else. Probably is, I've played a lot of games in my day. I like this shotgun though. The only thing I'm disappointed with is that I've been throwing ammo for it away. That's okay. So I wonder, if I shoot one and hit Z... Oh, that is so cool. So this is a slug. And then it's gonna be buckshot. Is it gonna be a slug again? Yes. Okay. That's actually pretty cool that you can load mixed ammunition. I can appreciate that. Okay, let's get in here. Jesus. Freaking shitty ass weather out there. Hey guys.
I'm listening, man.
Hey guys, you're all cool. You're all cool. Flip my light off, I don't need it. I'm over encumbered. We made it like just in time with that Hercules here.
Sup.
Hey there, found the materials you needed, so here you go. I searched the cement factory from top to bottom. Wow, I'm impressed. I'll make a note right here. Free labor and all repairs and upgrades. Holy hell, really? Literally free repair. You free repair my ass. Still, decidedly cheaper. Decidedly cheaper. I'm okay with that. I'm not gonna complain too much. Still, that's not free game. Why are you messing with my heart? So I think...
Later.
Let's see here. Yeah, we're gonna offload some junk, and then I'm gonna call it. So if you don't wanna watch me selling and all of my random crap to this guy right here, you're probably good to drop. Hello, my friend. How are you doing? Gonna keep this. Let's see, I'm using that, using those. I apparently picked up a pistol that I didn't mean to pick up. Get out of my inventory, Martha. See, that is that. He won't buy those, he will buy those, sell those. Grenades. I'm getting rid of some of these grenades. I don't need 20 grenades. I think I'm pretty happy with 8. In all truthfulness. Okay. Sell some vodka. Sell that. Sell some snossages. And I think that is about it. I don't use these 5.56 rounds, apparently. No, yeah, I do. Why does it highlight his gun but not my equipped one? Thanks, game. Alright. See ya. Let's go and stash our stuff, and then we're gonna call it. Next time, we're probably gonna find that guy's tools so that I can further upgrade my equipment. Hey there, buddy. Okay, so what can I afford to drop? I can get rid of these. I don't think, 19 med kits. I will go with 10. I'm actually gonna keep all of the bandages, I think. Yeah, they're only 0.5 kilograms. And these things are great. As you can see, they're twice as good as my current medkits with regards to health restoration. They're 4 times as good with wound healing, and they heal you faster. However, I'm gonna leave them behind because I'm at the point in the game now where, generally speaking, barring shotgun-wielding psychopaths, I'm not really getting one-shot by things, so I'm really not particularly worried about that yet. And we're gonna leave our helmet behind. Well, that thing's actually quite heavy, 4 kilograms. So that being done, I think we're good. I need to find some artifacts, actually. I've been kind of lax in using my scanner to find them. That's something that I'm actually probably going to want to start doing because they do give you some pretty useful benefits. However, that is not going to be in this episode. We are done for today. So as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope you had a good time, and I will catch you all next time in Let's Play Stalker, Call of Pripyat. Until then.